everyone. Welcome to my video. Today is Saturday, the 24th of August 2019. My name is Dan Kita from Thailand. In this video, I would like to talk about the true Dhamma or Nirvana for only people who have the most wisdom. If you are a little person who wants to attain Nirvana in this life, you have to listen to me early because I have attained Nirvana for past 16 years. I'm ready to help everyone on this earth attain Nirvana in this life. I'm ready. But are you ready? Aha! It's up to you. The topic to speak in this video is borrow the fictional language, describe hypothetical language to end suffering. From now on, I would like to talk about borrow the fictional language, describe hypothetical language to end suffering. Why did I say this? Let me explain. You know, this is dialogue of people in everyday life. What you see now in this dialogue, we call this it. What you see now in this dialogue, this is written language. If I say, "Hey Joe, how are you doing today?" "Pretty good, Mary. I was wondering if you would like to come to a party on Friday night. I'm free that night and the party sounds good." Now, I use spoken language to talk to you. I use spoken language, describe written language. Do you understand me? I use spoken language, describe written language. If I say, "Hey Joe, how are you doing today?" The same end I say, "Hey Joe, how are you doing today?" It becomes this sentence. I say, "Hey Joe, how are you doing today?" I say spoken language. It becomes written language like this. Do you understand? I say, "Hey Joe, how are you doing today?" I say with spoken language. Can you understand me? Okay. I say, "Hey Joe, how are you doing today?" Spoken language. It's mean. We write it like this. This is written language. We write it like this. And we read it like this. "Hey Joe, how are you doing today?" Do you understand me? Okay. "Hey Joe, how are you doing today?" "Pretty good, Barry. I was wondering if you would like to come to a party on Friday night. I'm free that night and the party sounds good." This is a dialogue of people in everyday life. Now I use spoken language. That's why written language. This is written language. I say now spoken language. Do you understand? Okay. And then I would like to talk about the music note value, the music theory. From now on, I would like to talk about spoken language of music. I would like to talk about spoken language in music. Let's support a guitar act to say like a human. Let's suppose a guitar act to say like a human. If people say, "Hey Joe, how are you doing today?" This is written language. Now I use spoken language. I say, "Hey Joe, how are you doing today?" Let's support a guitar act as to say like a human. A guitar say, Is it guitar say like a human? Let's support. A guitar act as. Is it spoken language of music? A guitar act as to say like a human. Can you understand me? Dialogue in every life of human. Human say, people say. People say, hey Joe, how are you doing today? And guitar will say, huh? A guitar act as to say like a human. You understand? I would like to talk about spoken language of music and written language of music. What you see now in this chart, we call written language of music. This is written language of music. Do you understand? Okay. A guitar will say, huh? I play guitar like this. It means guitar say, right human, let's support. Can you understand me? Okay. If a guitar say, when guitar say, two, three, four. Example one, a guitar say like this. This is example one is, example one is, from here to here, do, re, mi, fa, sol, la, ti, do. This is example one is written language of music. Example one is written language of music. Do, re, mi, fa, sol, la, ti, do. I say music. A guitar will say. A guitar say. A guitar act as to say. A guitar say like this. It become written language like this. A guitar say. Guitar say like this. We call spoken language of music. A guitar act as to say like a human. This is spoken language of music. It become written language. Written language in music. Example one. Example one is written language of music. We write it like this. Do, re, mi, fa, sol, la, ti, do. This is written language of music. A guitar act as to say this. The sound like this is mean written language. Two, three, four. I play like this. It's mean. Example one. Do you understand me? A guitar act as to say like a human. Now, a guitar say, this is spoken language of music. A guitar act as to say, can you understand me? Now, I'm playing a guitar. This is guitar act as to say. Akita say, spoken, this is spoken language of music. Akita act as to say like a human. Can you understand me? Okay. Example two, if we write it, write it. This is record. We write it. This is example two is written language of music. What you see now is written language of music. This note, each note, we call eighth note triplet. Each note, we call eighth note triplet in music. We write it, is written language in music. We write it like this. A guitar act as to say like this. 2, 3, 4. A guitar say like this. Can you understand me? Okay. And then I would like to show you the music note value. The music note value. The first one is the whole note. The second, the half note. The third, the quarter note. And the last one, the eighth note. What does it mean? The whole note is word. Whole note is word. Whole note is word. Four beat, like this. Whole note is word. Four beat. Like this. And half note. Get two beats like this. A quarter note is root. One beat like this. And the last note, eighth note, get half beat like this. Okay? Can you understand me? Example one, example two, we call. Written language of music. Written language of music. We write it, write it. Example one, we write it, write it. Do, re, mi, fa. Do, re, mi, fa, sol, ti, do. I say music. I say music language. Okay. Example two. Three, four. This is written language of music. Written language of music. Written language of music. Can you understand me? Okay. The music note value, the whole note, the half note, the quarter note, the eighth note. Example one is written language. Example two is written language. On the chart. It was created by human on this earth for communication, understanding temporarily. Here, these two. Dialogue of people in everyday life. Descendant, it was created by human on this earth for communication, understanding temporarily. Can you understand me? Okay. From now on, I would like to talk about the music theory. When we believe or accept that, this is music theory. When we believe or accept that, this is music theory. There will be many details of music theory follow. When we believe or accept that, this is music theory, there will be many details of music theory follow. Can you understand me? This is part of music theory. Okay, music theory. This is part of music theory. I would like to show you a C major scale. The C major scale consists of the note C, D, E, F, G, A, B, and C. It sounds like this. This is C major scale. There are 7 notes in the C major scale. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. The first note and the last note is the same sound we call from here to here. Octave and octave. It means I play this note. It means and the last note it means this note. I show you. Tum 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 tum. We call an octave of major scale. Can you understand me? There are 7 notes in major scale. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. The same note, C to C. Okay. Okay. This is the whole and half step. This is the whole and half step characteristic of the major scale. Must be memorized. This is whole and half step characteristic of the major scale. Must be memorized. Can you understand me? Okay. C to D, this curve is mean whole step. C to D, whole step. D to E, whole step. E to F, half step. This is broken red line. F to G, whole step. G to A, whole step. Whole step is half step. You must memorize whole and half step characteristic of the C major scale. C major scale. Each note of C major scale can be the root of chord. Each note of the C major scale can be the root of chord. From now on, I would like to talk about the diatonic chords in the key of C major. Diatonic chord in the key of C major. Okay. The note C becomes the root of C major chord. It means C major, a D minor, E minor, F major, G major, A minor, and the last chord is B minor 7 flat 5. Each note of the C major scale can be the root of chord. In this talk, I would like to show you diatonic chords in the key of C major. This is C major scale. Each note is C, D, E, F, G, A, B. The note C becomes the root of C major chord. The C major chord consists of the note C, E, and G. Note D become root of D minor chord. D minor chord consists of the note D, F, and A. And E become root of E minor chord. E, G, B, and F become root of F major chord. F, A, and C. And G, B, D. A major note A become root of A major chord A, C, and E. And the last chord is the B note become root of B minor flat 5. Okay. The C major chord consists of the note C, E, and G sound like this. D minor chord consists of the note D F and A. Okay. E minor chord consists of the note E, G, and B. F major chord consists of the note F, A, C, and G major chord consists of the note G, B, D, and so on. Can you understand me? What you see now, we call written language of music. Written language of music. What you see now? A guitar acts to say like a human. You see now, what you see now is written language. Dialogue is written language. Written language of people. People say, "Hey Joe, how are you doing today?" People say, "Hey Joe, how are you doing today?" It's spoken language. We say, "Hey Joe, how are you doing today?" We say it like it. We write it. If a guitar say like this. This is spoken language of music. A guitar say like this. We like it. Write it. This is written language of music. Written language of music. A guitar say like this. I do it like this. It's mean. Okay. A guitar act as to say like a human. Have you ever heard it before? Okay. This is. This dialogue is fictional language. This is fictional language. This is fictional language too. Fictional language of human used to say in everyday life. This is fictional language of human used to say in everyday life. This is fictional language of music. Can you understand me? Whole note, half note, quarter note, eighth note. Music theory. What you see now is written language of music. This written language of spoken language. This is written language. This dialogue and music note value, music theory. This just the fictional language. It doesn't mean literary language. Human on this earth create this and this for communication, understanding temporarily. In reality, we cannot prove. The saying, "Hey Joe, how are you doing today?" What does it mean? Aha! Why did you say it? If I ask you, hey man, the saying, "Hey Joe, how are you doing today?" Can you answer? What does it mean? If I ask you, "Hey man, the saying, hey Joe, how are you doing today?" What does it mean? Can you answer? Why did I say this? Does it sound strange? Why did I say this? Does it sound strange? I'm crazy? No. You know, the language we use in everyday life, it does not really exist. Using the language for communication to everyone on this earth, it seems that we can understand each other, but in reality, we have never understand each other and never understand anything. But we believe that we understand each other. Where can I find the meaning of understanding? Where can I find? the meaning of how are you doing today? What does it mean? This word. We were taught from birth to death to believe in this word. When you see this word, there will be a God. You see this word, there will be an image. In your thought. When you see this word, a God, there will be in your thought. Can you realize it? We were taught from birth to death to believe this word. This word is mean this thing. In reality, this word. In reality, this word. It doesn't mean bah, bah, bah. It doesn't mean this word. Can you understand me? That is how it said. We write it, we read it. A God, we were taught from birth to death to believe in the meaning of a God. It means, where can I find a God? Where can I find this word? This word and this thing. It's just what happened to the human mind to awareness through a mental phenomena. This word and this, it doesn't mean anything. It's just what happened to the human mind through awareness through a mental phenomena. Can you understand me? Okay. When I find this word, a book, there will be a book. There will be, aha, in your thought. There will be this. But this, and this word, it doesn't mean anything. It must be anything. Can you understand me? What does it mean? What does it mean? It's just what happening to the human mind through awareness. It doesn't mean a bottle of water. It doesn't mean a bottle of water. Aha! This word. This word. It doesn't mean. No. This, it doesn't mean anything. This word, it doesn't mean anything. Can you understand me? In this talk, I try to talk to you for understand about the language. The language we use in everyday life, LIT, it's just the fictional language. It doesn't mean real language. Whether spoken language and written language, both of these languages, is what's created by human on this earth for communication, understanding temporarily. But we cannot prove. We cannot prove the meaning of the language. What does it mean? The meaning of music note value. What does it mean? We were taught the meaning of music note value is mean. We were taught, hey Joe, how are you doing today? It's mean. We were taught to believe, I'm free that night and a party sounds good. We were taught to believe in the meaning of this sentence. This sentence is just a fictional language. We call it written language. I say, I'm free, that's right, and the practice sound good. I use spoken language. Spoken language become written language. Can you understand me? Can you understand me? Every story I convey in this video, you must try to understand every story I convey in this video. Even the meaning of the language, it does not really exist. You must try to understand. The meaning of understanding, it does not really exist. The meaning of understanding, it does not really exist. You know, using the language for communication to everyone on this earth, it seems that we can't understand each other. But in reality, we have never understand each other, and we never understand anything. But we believe that we can understand each other. Where can I find the meaning of understanding? Where can I find the meaning of understanding each other? Where can I find the meaning of wondering? The meaning of wondering, understanding. You know, every story I convey in this video, I use spoken language, describe hypothetical language. This is written language of music theory. This is written language of human on this earth. Both of these languages, in reality, it does not really exist. Can you understand me? I'm only one person on this earth that talk this story. I'm only one person in this earth that talk this story. Have you never heard it before? This and this. It's just the fictional language. It has no meaning as we understand it. We believe in the meaning of this dialogue and the meaning of the music note value and music theory because we have been taught from birth to death to believe in the meaning of it. Can you understand me? You know, I would like to say that the meaning of the language we use in everyday life is the barrier to achieving nirvana. Why did it say that? If you want to overcome anger, overcome suffering, you must try to understand this story very much as possible. If you want to overcome anger, overcome suffering, you must try to understand this story as much as possible. The language is the barrier to achieving nirvana. Why did it say that? If you can't understand what I say, you know, the meaning of spoken language and written language, it does not really exist. We believe in the meaning temporarily for communication, understanding, but we cannot prove the meaning of the language. We cannot prove the meaning of the language. What does it mean? Where can I find the meaning of, hey Joe, how are you doing today? Where can you find? Why did I say it? That sounds strange. Where can I find the meaning? Hey Joe, how are you doing today? Where can I find? And the meaning of, pretty good, Mary. I was wondering if you would like to come to a party on the Friday night. What does it mean? Ha ha! Why did I say it? It sounds strange. Have you ever heard it before? No. I want to say that the meaning of the language we use in everyday life is just a fictional language, whether spoken language and written language. It has no meaning as we understand it. And the most important is, it does not really exist. The human on this earth was created. The meaning of language. Can you understand me? Create the meaning of language for communication, understanding, temporarily. The meaning of this and this it in your thought, it in my thought. Where can I find the meaning of? And where can I find? We write it like this. We were taught to believe. We write it like this. We were taught to believe. This is written banquet. We write it like this. We read it like this. Ekita. Ekita. Elide. 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 We write it like this. Or maybe we read it like this. Ang bang dok kum sai. Did you understand me? Can you understand me? Ha ha ha! We write it, a guitar is mean. Or maybe we write it. It depends on how we want to teach to believe. How we want to teach to believe. How does the world teach me to believe? I will believe it. We write it. We were taught from birth to death to believe. We write it like this. We read it like this. Ekita. This word is mean. But elite. This word. It doesn't mean anything. This thing. It doesn't mean anything. It's just something happening to the human mind for perceiving raw mental phenomena. Can you understand me? If we write it like this, or maybe we read it like this. Apong dok kum sai, ha ha. Have you ever heard it before? Apong dok kum sai, ha ha. We write it like this. We read it. Apong dok kum sai. It mean, ha ha. Apong dok kum sai. We write it like this. We were taught from birth to believe. Akita. Or maybe it depends on how we want to teach to believe. We write it. Write it. We read it. Apong dok kum sai. It mean, maybe. Do you understand? I want to tell you the meaning of the language we use in every life, whether spoken language or written language, it does not really exist. It does not exist. We believe in the meaning temporarily for communication understanding. Why did I talk about this story? You know. We cannot find the meaning of this word. Hey Joe, how are you doing today? This word, wondering and understanding. If I ask you, the word wondering, what does it mean? The word understanding, what does it mean? Where can I find the meaning of understanding? It's out here. Where can I find the meaning of wondering? Why did it say this? Does it sound strange? Have you ever heard someone say like me before? No! I'm only one person on this earth. Talk about it. Do you understand? The language we use in everyday life, whether spoken language and written language, we believe in the meaning of the language, temporarily understanding for communication, but in reality, we cannot prove. The meaning of the language we use in everyday life, what does it mean? Where can I find the meaning of the fictional language? The language we use in everyday life, it's just the fictional language. It doesn't mean really a language. Can you understand me? In this story, I try to talk to you for understanding about the language. The meaning of the language is does not really exist. Do you understand me? We believe in the meaning temporarily understanding communication. We cannot prove the meaning of the language. What does it mean? One plus one is equal to five. It's wrong. We write it like this. One plus one is equal to five. It's wrong. Where can I find the meaning of 1 plus 1 is equal to 5? 1 plus 1 is equal to 5 is wrong. is wrong. One plus one is must be two. It's correct. One plus one is must be two. It's correct. One plus one is must be two. One plus one is equal to five. It's wrong. Where can I find the meaning of one plus one equal to five? Or one plus one is equal to two. Where can I find? This sentence is just a fictional language. It depends on how we want to teach to believe. We write it. Or maybe we read it. Eng bong rok pung kung sai tai e cho kho. Eng bong rok kung sai e po ku kho. I say it mean. Eng bong rok kung sai e po kho is mean. One plus one is equal to two. Ha ha! That sounds strange. One plus one is equal to five. It's wrong. If I say, พี่ใดตรงต่ออับปกอตุกตุกพี่ใดปกตูไอโซอตุกตุก it means one plus one is equal to five. That sounds strange. Why did you say it? It depends on how we want to teach to believe. I want to tell you, the meaning of the language we use in everyday life is not really exist. It cannot replace.The language we use in every life, it cannot replace. It cannot use. The language we use in every life, it cannot be used to replace what you see or hear now. The language we use in every life, it cannot be used to replace what you see or hear now. Please bear in mind. Now today we believe in the man. Now today we believe in the meaning in the language because we were taught to believe, and we believe it understanding temporarily for communication. Do you understand me? Okay. I try to talk to you about the language. I use the language describe the language. That for. You know.We cannot find the meaning of understanding each other. You must try to understand every story I convey in this video. Even the meaning of the language it does not really exist. You must try to understand every story I convey in this video. Even the meaning of the language it does not really exist. You must try to understand every story I convey in this video.Even the meaning of the language it does not really exist in order to not have to understand each other anymore. Please bear in mind, why did I say this? If you can't understand every story I convey in this video, I forbid you to ask. Let's see.If you can't understand every story I convey in this video, I forbid you to ask Dhamma problem categorically, and you must stop answering right problem, Dhamma problem categorically, because the meaning we use in Dhamma conversation, the meaning of language we use in answering in Dhamma conversation, it does not really exist.It has no meaning as we understand it. Do you understand me? If you can't understand every story I convey in this video, I forbid you to ask Dhamma problem categorically. And don't ask life problem categorically. Because the language we use in Dhamma conversation, it does not really exist.How to get rid an ego? This is the question. How to overcome anger? How to handle idea? Suffering, happiness, anxiety, anger, love. All this word is just the fictional language, written language, fictional language. It has no meaning as we understand it. If I ask you, the sentence, how to get rid of ego, how to overcome anger, what does it mean? Why did it say that? That is how saying. If you can't understand every story I convey in this video, I forbid you to ask Dhamma problem categorically, because the meaning we use in speaking in every life is that not really exist, but we believe in the meaning of language because we were taught from birth to death to believe in the meaning of the language. Can you understand me? I forbid you. All right, I said, this is the reason that I have to borrow a fictional language to create content and story to talk to you for understanding about the true Dhamma in Buddhism. If you want to overcome anger, overcome suffering, and finally you want to attain your righteous life, you must use the method of knowing our thought, or knowing our body movement. Like it. You must use the method of knowing our thought or knowing our body movement to end a false suffering. You must stop asking, answering Dhamma problem and life problem categorically, because the meaning of language you use in asking, answering Dhamma problem, life problem, it does not really exist. As I mentioned before, can you understand me? Can you understand me? Aha! It sounds strange. It sounds strange. In this talk, I try to talk to you. I don't teach you anything. All right, that's it. This is the reason. You know, Dhamma or food or Nirvana is not possible to teach one another because there is nothing to teach. The true Dhamma in Buddhism is a pure mental, it's universal truth. It doesn't have the fictional language. It's not in Pratibhidok. The ultimate wisdom in Buddhism is not in the teaching of monk or nun, but it's in your thought. If you are wondering, or if you want to know something, you have to use the method knowing your thought, knowing our thought, or knowing our body movement to end suffering. Can you understand me? I don't teach you anything, and I don't teach you to believe me, but I have to borrow the fictional language to create content and story to talk to you for understanding about the ultimate wisdom in Buddhism is in your thought. It's not in the teaching of monk or nun. It's not in the teaching of anyone on this earth. Can you understand me? I don't teach you anything. When you listen to me, you must try to understand every story I convey. When you listen to me, you must try to understand every story I convey. We consider along as I said over and over again, until it goes deep into your heart. Then you will understand it. And finally, you will have the opportunity to attain Nirvana in this life. You know, every Dhamma teacher on this planet will teach you to believe every story they convey, and you will believe it. But I don't teach you anything. I don't teach you to believe me. I'm different from the others. Aha! I'm different from the others because I don't teach you anything. I don't teach you to believe me. I have to borrow the fictional language to create content and story to talk to you for understanding, temporarily for communication. Can you understand me? From now on, you must stop asking, answering Dhamma problem, right problem categorically, and change to use the method of knowing our thought and knowing our body movement if you want to overcome anger and overcome suffering. And finally, you will have attained Nirvana in this life. Please bear in mind.